Hey guys, how are you doing? So yep, like the title says, the coolest and I think one of the biggest news of the 2013 knife related news is against Ultimate Steel from Knife Rights. It's a raffle I've tried to advocate many times last year. Some of you guys did support and did end up winning some cool stuff, and which I was super happy about. I also donated last year, actually not expecting, not doing it for winning, just because I do, you guys know that I do support Knife Rights a lot. I put Knife Rights everywhere. I'm a big supporter of, big believer of what they fight for. And I ended up winning a lot too, so it was really cool. And definitely this year I did the same thing again, and I upped the ante a little bit more because I donated a big knife, big expensive knife for the price, and I again did the purchase of $500 for raffle tickets. So hopefully this year is gonna be even more and better as the outcome for Knife Rights. I don't know how it was last year. I know I was surprised that I ended up winning so many, which led me to believe that there wasn't as many people donating, which was kind of bummer. I mean, it was a good thing for me, but it was a bummer in, you know, the actual cost. So I hope that this year is gonna be a lot more people donating. There's gonna be a lot more winners too, because there is $100,000, over $100,000 worth of prices, which is insane. Doug Greer is my personal friend. I've hang out with him. I came with him 5 days. I always hang out at every knife show. I meet him, always talk a fair amount together. He's a great person, very knowledgeable person, and very involved in all knife related stuff, and actually not just knife related stuff, but also survival preparedness and a lot of other things. You know, a lot of people don't even know, for example, the personal beacons, you know, the locators when you get lost as a hiker, to, you know, a mountaineer and stuff like that. He's actually very involved in that too. So he is a very cool person, very knowledgeable person, and he has the connections to get such a great event like this going. So I want to just give you a quick rundown. So you can, even as little as $20 donation can actually put the name in the hat and you can win something really cool. Winner always picks his prize, you know, so in the order of, you know, first winner picks the first prize, you know, whichever he wants, and so on and so on. So you not only win a prize, but you actually win a prize that you want, which is cool. It's two parts. It's early bird drawing. I'm not sure about the dates. You can find it here if you look into it. It's early bird drawing. There is a small portion of the prices are for the, you know, people who donated to certain until a certain date, and then the main drawing is later on for the rest of the prices, the really cool stuff. So you can get from $20 to $500, and if you donate more, you get extra tickets, you know, extra raffles, extra entries. And then when you get to, like, let's see here, $100, you get the free H&K knife. Then $200 gets you free Azula, and all of these are actually engraved with Knife Rights. So that's the cool part about it, that, you know, let's say you donate $100, yes, you will get the cheap H&K knife, but it has a logo on it with Knife Rights, so it kind of has a meaning for you that you were a supporter. You donated the $100 for a really good cause. Then you have the Azula. Then if you have $300, you have two Azulas, I think. Oh no, it's one. Oh, $400 are two Azulas from Essie. Essie is a big supporter. If you look through the prices, there's a lot of Essie knives, which is really cool. And $500 actually gets you that Benchmade Emissary, which, let me show you. I have the one here from the last year, and it's actually one of my most treasured knives. I did EDC it for a while, now it's a collector piece. It just, I love it. This little engraving, the laser etching on the blade, is just, it means so much to me. It's insane. Very cool knife, very nice knife, very classy knife, and it's just really cool with that etching on the blade and on the handle. And the new one is even really cooler. Now you have black handle, again you have the logo on the handle, and then you have the whole blade is actually etched with the American flag and the sharper essential tools, essential rights, which is awesome motto and everything. So really excited about that. Hopefully I will be fast enough. I'm sure that it just started today, so I should be fast enough to actually be within the limited supplies, you know, while the supplies last. Little appendix. So you have some big names supporting, you know, Ted Nugent, as always, is always there with some really cool and expensive 911, some special edition. I think it also comes with the Wilson Tactical knife, some autograph knives by some big names in the industry and in the politics, and then expensive custom knives, swords, daggers. You see, there's a really cool AR-15 custom knife, tote bag. A lot of famous makers that you've seen, even me doing the videos from the shows, you see them here. Everybody, a lot of people donated, which is great to see. Well, this is a Hinder, was there. Hinder is always a supporter. Here you see RJ Martin, very cool knife. You know, these are all knives over $2,000. Some really cool pen, a Rockstead knife. Dalton Holder, that's a big name in the industry. Alshowitz. I know. Oh, look, Kirby Lambert, very, very cool dude. A lot of, I don't even know many of these knife makers, but there are a lot of them. Chris Reeves also always supports, so that's great. And check this out. You know this guy? That's the knife I donated. I don't know, some of you guys might see it on my website. If you did look at the new website, that, you know, quote unquote website, that looks amazing. That the professional picture of the knife, it looks like so much better than actually in reality it looks, but super, super nice. It was done by Eric Peggy. Peggy, I think, professional photographer, like kind of volunteer to take a pictures for the knife makers who donated the knives, which is amazing. Tim Breeden, another great guy. I've had a fair share of talking on the shows. Amazing guy. You see Brian Ty. Lot of famous makers donated prices, and it's gonna be amazing giveaway. Not giveaway, but raffle. And I just hope that Knife Rights will collect some decent money to fight for the cause, because they do a lot, you know. Like recently, a lot of you guys know that the TSA is ready to approve certain knives, some basic slip joints knives, to be allowed as a carry-on on the planes. Now, of course, that raises a huge, oh no, you cannot do that in the politics, no. So, but it makes sense, it's normal. And Knife Rights, it's actually one of the things they do, is they're gonna try to support TSA in that ruling, because TSA wants to do it, and some politicians and, you know, some parties are against it. So that's just one of the many fights that Knife Rights are involved in. They, you know, pushing people to, you know, email these and these people in the certain city halls and state parliaments and stuff like that. So again, guys, if you can afford it, you know, donate. Even if you can afford the $20, I highly suggest even $5. You know, if every one of us, every one person who carries a knife and likes knives, even if every one of us would donate $5, which is nothing, you know, look at the knives we have, look at the knives we buy, look at the money we spend on the knives. Even if just every one of us would donate $5, they would have so much money that they could really take on to fight for a cause. And I thank Doug Reeder and everybody who donated, everybody who sponsored, everybody who, you know, was doing, was promoting them. I thank every one of you guys, and I thank you guys for watching, and I hope you will join the support. So thanks for watching, guys. Take care, stay safe, and remember, don't cut yourself.